So Emma is Helena's lead stylist. After 10 years working in retail fashion, including her own mobile boutique business, Emma found her calling in personal styling. She teaches clients to express their fashion sense and style in authentic and practical ways that fit all aspects of their life, creating a trusting, honest relationship that guides clients to their personal goals and what is what matters most to Emma. This is Emma Martin.
Thank you so much for coming. This is such a wonderful turnout. I'm so excited to teach you all tonight the basics of how to build a wardrobe. We're going to go through these two racks and this table. I know some people have already spotted some things on this table that really like. I have to say that this handbag has already been claimed by Betty. You can take it up with her after we're done. So the goal for our session today is building a wardrobe to reflect who you are right now, not the future you, not the summer you, not the you 10 pounds lighter, the woman that you are right now. That's really important because you want to feel comfortable and beautiful no matter what when you go out the door. So you want your closet to reflect that. So our first rack that we have right here is what I call our necessities. They're our foundation pieces. There's not a lot of color on here. The color and the fun comes over this rack, where this is where you get to express your personality, showcase who you are through pattern and color, and then to top it all off, the finishing touches that give those pops to your outfit. I notice a lot of you ladies are wearing scarves. The accessories, so scarves, necklaces, bracelets, sunglasses, handbags, belts, all great things to cap off an outfit. So your closet is the first place that you look every day, but it's sometimes the last place that we think about. So when you're starting to build your wardrobe, you're gonna go and you wanna get these necessity foundation pieces. So we're gonna start with a layering tank. This is a tank that you can wear underneath a sheer blouse, underneath a sweater that might have a little bit of crochet detail. I picked two different types just to give you an idea. This one is shorter in length. It's lighter in fabrication. So those of you who don't like things that are super close to your body, this would be a great tank for you. I picked four different colors too. So we have our white, cream, nude, and black. All super easy. You don't have to think about like, does this blue match the blue of, you know, whatever details happening. And then for those of you who might like a longer tank, I picked this one. It's got stretch to it. It's got a little bit of a slimming factor to it. Nothing like a Spanx feeling where you're really sucked in. It's just something that gives you a nice smooth line underneath whatever you're wearing. So then we're gonna move over to tanks that you could wear as an actual piece, something that you could throw a cardigan over. And I did three colors in this too, a white, a gray, and a black. They're all very different, but it's the same idea of just being easy in the way that they're styled. Also too, as you're looking at this rack, you might be like, Emma, I have some of these pieces. I've got this covered. That's wonderful. I'm really glad. The next question I would ask you is, what's the state of your white tank top? Is it gray? Do we have a little pilling happening? So that is like, that would be a replace. If it's in fresh tip-top shape, fantastic. So then, these are a great layering long sleeve tee. This is one of our most popular pieces that we carry in our store. People love them, they come in a lot of different colors. But again, it fits slimly to the body, so it doesn't add bulk to sweaters, jackets, dresses. Sometimes when you have a short sleeve dress and you're like, oh, I wish I could wear it when it's kind of cold outside. This kind of tee is perfect for that because it gives your arm coverage and takes a dress from, you know, a warm weather dress into a cool weather dress. Then we have all sorts of professional women. So these are basic professional tops. So we have this really great tank top that's in this kind of silky fabric. That is great because it's loose fitting, so it would be appropriate to wear with an open blazer. I have this gray for a more casual office setting. Gray V-neck, it looks like it dips really low, it doesn't. It's very appropriate higher. These two pieces are slim fitting to the body. They're very different in the necklines, but both have that shorter length so that they fit really nicely when you're wearing a higher waisted pant or a skirt and you don't want to add that extra fabric or bulk and you don't have to worry about tucking it in. Whereas these pieces, they give you that option of being able to tuck them in to your pants or your skirt. So then for our bottoms, I love a pencil skirt, but this is not for everybody. Some people don't feel comfortable in something that's so tight fitting. So then I would suggest an A-line skirt, something with a little bit more movement. And they're both to about right above your knee to mid kneecap, so that you won't feel like, oh, if I bend over, all my business is going to be hanging out of it. Don't want that. That's not a good look. So these both fit that bill. And then for our professional pant, this May pant we just got in from Ecru, and it has been flying out of here because it feels like a yoga pant. It's comfortable, but it's sleek. It doesn't have that athletic feel to it. So for those ladies who like a wider leg pant, this is perfect. For those of you who prefer a slimmer pant, this Springfield is also, they call it the Springfield pant. It's a slim, not tapered leg, and it's not a straight leg, but it's also not like a legging style. So it fits close to the body without being tight like a legging. So this would be a good pant for you. Now moving along to dresses. I have three different sleeve lengths. Everybody knows you need a little black dress. There isn't a woman around who doesn't own a black dress that there is their go-to piece. And if you don't have one, you really should need one because you should get one because it's that piece that you go to, you put it on, you feel great, you can jazz it up with some jewelry, and it's an all-occasion piece. Then I have something that is a nice empire kind of A-line dress, really easy jersey with a nice cowl neck draping. For those of you who like a little cap sleeve, it can go. You can wear a cardigan over it when it gets warm outside. You can not layer it. And then we have the three-quarter sleeve. Again, really simple color, simple silhouette, but very easy. The most important thing for me when we're thinking about our foundation pieces is that the fabric feels nice, because you don't want to be doing this all the time, like pushing stuff down, feeling itchy. So when you're thinking like, okay, I like a black dress, but I want something in a jersey, you can definitely have a jersey dress that looks really slick, pulled together, and professional. So in terms of like layering pieces, we have a couple different options. This is just a traditional black little cardi. We have this one that's a little open cardi that's a little bolero style. This looks fantastic with dresses. It just pulls together the outfit. I know a lot of you work in offices that are really chilly, so these two are great options for you. And then we have kind of this marled knit. Yeah, it's fantastic in a really easy color. So as I'm going through the rack, like after I go through all the pieces, I'm gonna mix and match within this rack. It doesn't have a lot happening, but there are definitely a lot of outfit options, so we will get to that. A black blazer. Everybody should have one. It's, again, that go-to over piece. I love leather, and I had a good karma cash in because this showed up today. I really wanted it for this event. It's beautiful, and it's not too edgy. It's age appropriate. It's got the nice jersey draping. It's something that gives you a little kick to that outfit. So I love a leather jacket. Patricia is rocking a color tonight, but I love that. Then we have a simple outerwear piece. This jacket you could wear to work. feel pulled together and professional, but also for weekend wear. You've got your little coat on. Jean jacket. Love a jean jacket. Beth and I were discussing, she was like, oh, I have this dress, it feels really fancy, it's really bold, how do I tone it down? And I said, jean jacket. Just put it over and you're good to go. Jean jackets have been around forever. Many of you have seen the trend cycle through, in and out. So if you feel like, oh, that's too trendy for me to own a jean jacket, it's not. It's a staple that's been around, gonna stay around. It's just the cut of your jacket that you wanna make sure it's got good lines and it's tapered towards your body instead of being like that boxy 80s kind of vibe mm-hmm. that, you know, a lot of 14 to 15 year old girls are rocking, right? And then we have my favorite Prairie Underground cloak hoodie. This is one of, we've had Prairie since we've opened, right, for 10 years. I own this particular color. And today I was really sad I didn't have a blue one because the outfit that I was wearing really needed a blue Prairie. It's one of those things that I could be wearing my pajamas and then I put this on. Hello, awesome. I will show you because it really does. I'm wearing all black so you won't get the full effect. But just imagine, oh, I need to go get a cup of coffee and I look crazy and my hair's a mess. But voila! I am sleek now.
Yes. I have actually seen people wearing this in a different color.
Yes! You can't miss them. They're a very dramatic kind of piece, but it's so easy because you could be wearing a pair of jeans and a t-shirt or your workout gear, and then it's like zipped up, polished person. Okay, so now we're going to go into our denim. Denim, three different washes, a light wash, a medium wash, and a dark wash. Dark wash is good for those casual business days in the office where you want to look pulled together, but you want to be in jeans. Dark wash is your way to go. Medium wash is great for every day, just, you know, day to night, weekends, whatever. Light wash is good for those springtime, summery months where you have a lot of lighter tops that you're wearing. These are all different cuts, so it's just a matter of what cut you prefer. Do you like a straight leg, do you like a boot cut, or do you like a skinny? And that's for you to decide. I won't give you the, like, everybody can wear a skinny, because not everybody likes a skinny. And then if you are not a jean person, chinos. A nice khaki and a great easy color is a good alternative. And then the necessity of a trend that I remember when I was working at Forever 21, I was like, oh, leggings? What's that all about? That's going to go away. Well, here we are a long time later, and they've only gotten fancier. I own fake leather ones. I own ones with zippers on them. These I'm actually wearing right now. We got these in October, and we sold out of them like in 2 weeks. They're high-waisted, and they have a little bit of a control top to them, so it's just like, whoop, slims you right down, super comfortable, one size fits most on these, so for ladies who are a little bit more petite, you're going to have extra fabric at the bottom, too. But this is a great thing to wear with tunics like what I'm wearing. A dress is also a good alternative, a big chunky cardigan, all wonderful for leggings when your pants are mad at you or you're mad at them or you're just feeling like really getting dressed. So within this, I'm going to put together a quick outfit. So, okay, I have a coffee meeting at 8:30 in the morning. I don't know what to wear. I'm going to do this shirt, this skirt, and then I'm feeling like I want to be a little bit edgy. So I'm going to do my faux leather jacket. Does someone else have a scenario that they can think of that they need to get dressed from? Anybody?
Meeting a friend and then a networking event afterwards.
Nighttime. I love it. Okay. So we're meeting our friend in the morning. So we're going to do this with this jean jacket. Then in our car, we are going to have a blazer to put over it. Okay? I went to work. I am wearing this tank and these slimmer pants. I'm freezing cold. I forgot my, I don't have an over thing. Oh, I'm gonna just put on my little cardigan. Or I could put on this little cardigan. Don't have to be afraid of mixing colors or staying within the same color family. You can go outside of the box. I'll do one more outfit. So it's the weekend. I've got a lot of errands to do. So I'm gonna put on my white tank with, hi ladies. My white tank with my jeans, and then I got my prairie piece, but then my husband surprises me and he's like, I would love to take you out for dinner. Thank you, love. I'm gonna put on a nice sweater and then I'm gonna add some bedazzly jewels.
Wow.
And I got dressed up. okay, so ladies, these are all the basics. These are the foundations. So let's move over to our fun. We're gonna talk about trends. I'm gonna talk about them for like 2 minutes. Because not everybody likes the word trendy. They're scared of it, or it makes them feel uncomfortable, or I'm too old, I'm too young, I don't know what to do. We have some trends that are completely palatable that anybody in this audience could wear. Acid wash, simple little tank you put on with jeans for the weekend. Typography / scenic kind of tees. This is so cute because you've got the typography on the back, so you could cover it up if you don't feel like someone seeing this. I see London, I see France. You can put a coat over it. And then it's like, wow, you have this great graphic tee. Kimonos are huge. They have been for probably 2 seasons now. This is just a really easy breezy kind of light piece that could go over a dress, go over a t-shirt, go over a tank. And then we have military inspired. This jacket, I wouldn't consider, it is on trend, but I wouldn't consider it trendy because military-inspired has been around for a long time. Color army green never goes out of style. So when you're thinking about your trend pieces, there's 2 things that you could keep in mind. You don't need to spend a lot of money on them. None of these pieces cost a lot. And you want to find things that reflect your personality that don't make you feel uncomfortable when you're wearing it. Like if you get a t-shirt that says, I love kale, I hope you do love kale. I hope you do. You want to rock that kale t-shirt.
We didn't plan that.
Yeah.
We totally
didn't plan this, did we?
I did not. I just saw that t-shirt online. So that's So then we're going to move into our basics that are not so basic. So what I would say, if you came in and saw me, you're like, oh, I'm looking for a top I could kind of wear. I'm like, oh, a not so basic basic. So this Ella Moss top is fantastic because, oh, it's got this beautiful cobalt blue. But then when we turn it around, oh, she's so gorgeous because she's got this beautiful crepe fabric in the back. So it's something with a little bit more volume to it. A basic white long sleeve shirt. It's got this nice tie detail at the top. And then we have, this is really a sweatshirt, but it doesn't look anything like a plain sweatshirt because it's got the stripe and the florals. For work, we could do some short sleeve tops, all beautiful patterns, all have something a little bit extra to them. What do we love?
Yes.
The blue one.
She was telling this me what was
that
me.
One.
How does she
that whole
that?
Section is her as Maria.
So,
but that shirt is so cute.
We all had a moment with this tank when it came in. 100% silk. And
it kind of makes me think of Alice in Wonderland. I don't know why.
Yes. Well, one of the girls, the store manager over in Belmont, was like, this is a take on a Gucci print from like the 60s. It kind of looks like Gucci in there. So then this tank is a lot of fun because sometimes clothes can do a little bit more than just being a tank top. This one is what I call a twofer. So we have this pattern and then, oh, it's reversible. So we do a more black
one.
So it's like, oh, where did you get that shirt? Oh, it's just out of my closet. No, I'm gonna trick everyone. For long sleeve shirts, this is great for work. This would be good for cocktails after work. This one's a great weekend wear, kind of peasant blouse with the little details on the top. And then we have a simple floral, again, breezy, light fabrics. And then for our over pieces, we have this great open kind of weave cotton sweater, super easy. These two sweater coats, totally different fabrications, do the same job. So it's just a matter of if you like the chunky knit or the lighter knit. And with these, it's like you could pair this together, you know, for a little wow factor. You could tone it down. You could tone it down and do a little navy number under it. That's too bold. And then for the purple, it's something like we could go a little trendy, do it that way. Or for a more simple look, we could just do the simple white tank. This jacket is a great coat. It's super cute. It's got the really nice boxy cut, but the texture on it is what makes it fun. It just looks like a simple white jacket, but then when you get up close to it, you feel it, you look at the detail of the pattern, it adds that little oomph to just what would be a simple white blazer. Then for dresses, these are multi-purpose. Both appropriate for a wedding on the Cape, or a date night at the beach, or a seafood restaurant. I don't know, I'm really fiending for those two things. Or a vacation to Cabo, one of the two. Both great pieces, both really easy. Brown shoes, and you're done. Everybody pretty much should own a pair of brown shoes. You could do a peep toe.
Shoes are
shades.
Like,
what shade?
I love all this stuff, and then I'd be like, what do I wear for shoes?
Okay, so most of the stuff on this rack on your basic foundation necessities, black shoes. When we go over to like these dresses, these are like your fancy going out kind of better than a basic black, both of them. This you could do with a colored shoe, or you could do it with a basic black pump, or you could do a nude. So if you had in your wardrobe a black, a nude, and then a more chocolate brown, and then one color for a pop of fun, that would be totally good, like those four pairs of shoes. I don't like to buy in bulk unless it's like something like a tank top or a layering piece. I think there should be variety within our footwear. So if you're going to have a closed-toe black pump, don't get the same in taupe. Get something a little bit different, something with like a peep toe or ankle strap. Because I know I struggle with that same thing too in my closet. It's like, oh, if only I had this pair of shoes. And so once you get those basic kind of categories down for your footwear, it makes it a lot easier. And then this dress is good with boots. You could do this with a flat, you could do it with a sandal. The most important thing is the multifunctionality of each piece, so that you can think of multiple situations that you could wear it in. So when you pick it up, you're not like, oh, where am I going to wear this to? It's like, I know I could wear this dress to go out to the grocery store if I wanted to, and I wouldn't look like I was too dressed up. But I also know that I could go out to dinner with my girlfriends, and I would feel cute. So then we are going to end with these jazzy pants. Trisha loves them. These, so a lot of people like pattern pants. It's like, wow, what, this is a lot. But if you take this pant and you pair it with a simple white tank, okay, I've already made it a little bit more palatable. But then you could say, all right, I'm going to wear it with my jean jacket. And that's a little bit cuter, more fun. Or I could tone it down a little bit further and just do a simple cardigan with it. So it's just, you don't have to think like, oh, I have something super bold. Like Beth was telling me, I don't know what else to do with it. You just, if you have the basic pieces from the beginning part of your wardrobe, then adding these things in won't be as intimidating. So then what we would do to just add those little finishing touches, I've dressed this mannequin in what would be like an easy go-to outfit, all black. It's a great uniform for so many people. And I have so many customers who come in, you know, mid-February, like, oh, I just wear black. And then we'll pull some color, and they'll walk out with more black clothes. Because it's just easy. It's just easy. So, it happens, and I'm not judging, because clearly. So I'm in this all-black outfit, but I want to feel a little bit, I want to make it a little happier. So I'm going to take a scarf that has some color in it, and I'm going to put this scarf on. We'll just do that. And then I'm not going to go for the basic black bag. I'm going to do a brown bag with it because that adds a little bit more interest. And then if you wanted to take a step further with your footwear, you could do something. You could pull a color from, you know, the scarf. You could do a yellow shoe if anybody has a real shoe lady. A yellow shoe or a blue shoe just to give it a little bit more of a pop. So accessories are a super easy way to do that. Again, like these add a belts, this is the belt that never makes you feel bad about yourself because it expands with you, right? And you can tie it in a bunch of ways like I did with this one over here. You can do a wrap and then tuck it in the back and it stays. So if we did this on her, like that adds a lot of interest to what would otherwise be a very simple outfit.
It's very nice.
Yeah, and it looks really chic. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So then we could do our basic black bag, but it's not so basic because it has this laser cut detail. And then, oh, someone asked you out for dinner after, and inside that bag is another bag that's metallic silver, right? And it's like, I'm ready to go. I love statement jewelry. I think it's a fantastic way to bring in the eye to an outfit, like just adding, I know this might be a little over the top for a lot of people, but just adding that, it's just a whole, like, brings your eye right in. It's a very inexpensive way to create a different kind of outfit. Like for, you know, $30, you can take something super plain and turn up the volume on it really easily. Also, these little bags, it's like an accessory that can do a little bit more for you. This bag can be a wristlet, you know, for when you don't want to have a lot of stuff with you, or it can be a crossbody. It's got the two different strap options. So it's looking for things that are not just going to pile up in your closet. Like when you go home, which I hope many of you do, maybe not tonight, carve out that time to spend in your closet. Like take those bins out to under your bed, in the basement, in the closet. Dump them all out and just look at it and say, what is all this stuff? What am I doing? If you haven't worn it within the past year and it's still got the tags on it, you're not going to wear it. I'm so sorry, but it's not going to happen. You need to say goodbye. You need to say, you will make someone else happy. Because all that, I would hate for someone to come tonight and be like, okay, I'm going to add this, this, and this, without taking stock of what you own already. Because you're just gonna add stuff on top of stuff, and that's not the point. The point is to have easy dressing so that you can go into your closet, open it up, not feel bombarded by things that don't fit, that are all raggedy, that you've never worn but you should wear, all those kind of emotional, guilty feelings that we have with our closets. It's kind of a bad relationship sometimes, you know? And you look at it and you want to open up and be like, oh, I know that I can wear this top with these jeans and this coat and I'm ready for my meeting, you know, with so-and-so. Because, like I keep on saying, when you walk out the door, you should feel like the best version of yourself. You should feel beautiful, you should feel confident, you should feel ready to go, and you shouldn't be thinking about what you're wearing. You should be wearing your outfit, your clothes shouldn't be wearing you. That makes sense. So does anyone have any questions? Yes.
I actually do.
Yes.
Can we talk about biases?
What do you mean?
Not a clothes bias, but what we were raised with, like these bad ideas that your mom planted in you.
Like you never look good in green? It happens.
It's definitely true, and believe me, at my age, I've still got some of my mom in me. So let's take those fancy pleated pants.
These ones
are absolutely spectacular and fun, and woo, that is great. But I would never, because I was taught never to do this, I would take a tank top and put it with that, but I'd never take anything that looks like cotton and put it on top of that.
Why?
I have no idea. I feel like you have to go over to your basics and get a really nice silk draped tank top to wear with that.
But doesn't, okay, so how do you feel saying that out loud? Like, how did that
feel? So free.
So you are free.
It's weird to me. It's like, why would you take something that you would put under a jeans jacket, which I love that little cottony.
Yeah.
It's so awesome. That goes with the jean jacket and maybe some, you know, a funky little skirt. Okay. But those wicked pants. Those wicked pants call for a really, you know.
And I love that.
Yeah, dressy,
I love that. If it were me, I would do something with like voluminous sleeves off the shoulder.
That would just
but
be
that's
wrong.
Like fantasy.
I don't see those as dressy.
Right? No, and it's great.
If my mom was still alive and I walked downstairs wearing the cotton with those pants, my mom would say,
and you know what you would say to her? You'd be like, Mom, I'm fire.
And we were just saying, we don't see those pants as dressy.
They don't have to be. It's all what you made. So if you don't think these are dressy pants, you wouldn't wear them for a dressy occasion.
No, I would, but I'm just saying, I think they're more versatile than just seeing as dressy.
Yeah, okay.
And I would like that.
Yeah.
What I don't like is I don't like the jean jacket with that.
See, that's your preference.
That's right.
You wouldn't feel comfortable, and you wouldn't feel like fire when you walked out the door. So you want to put those things together.
But also, there's a height issue, too.
Yes.
I would not wear those pants. I'm just way too short.
Exactly.
I look at those pants on a tall woman, they would look stunning.
Exactly.
So I would never think twice, not because I don't like them. I just know I can't pull it off.
So exactly.
My height.
Certainly
not my personality.
Right.
But, yeah, it's a height thing.
I totally agree with you. There's so many customers that are on the petite side that it's like, I'd have to get this hem 12 inches, and that becomes a struggle.
Even if I did that, they wouldn't look right on me. It's too much pattern for me.
So you would not buy those pants.
Yeah.
I'm not going to hand you those pants and say, and that's okay, but you could do something different. You could flip it. You could do the pattern on top and the solid on the bottom.
Right.
It's not so much like I'm saying, these are just examples of pattern and how to mix them. These are preferences of mine. They're not your preferences. I'm not saying you have to get this exact print because this is amazing. We all love it. It's all about if you think a lot about the pattern and what colors and this and that, that's taking the ease out of it. And you get hang up and stuff. Did I answer your question?
Because I think in a shop like this, if you put those pants on, one of the women who works here would say to you, that's what I like about shopping in smaller shops, is that you actually have somebody that will give you an honest, straight answer and say, no, but actually, these would work.
Yes, exactly. I would hand you a cropped pant and say, why don't we try those today? Yes. Betty.
Can you put together an outfit with the khaki army jacket? Mm. I just bought one of those 4 days ago.
Done.
I love those.
I love too. That jacket. I just bought that top. I know, I love that.
That's what I love all that.
That's
too.
Awesome. Okay.
See, done. Two minutes of that.
On a white jacket.
Yes.
So it's March 16th now. Can you wear that now, or do you have to wait until like Memorial Day?
Oh my gosh. Please. I am going to set this rule that you cannot wear white past a certain time because just throw it out. Just throw it out and say goodbye and never let it bother you because winter white happened all winter. So no one's going to look at you when you walk in and be like, so just throwing that out. You can wear this right now. You could wear this in December if you wanted to.
So all my friends wear their kimonos now, and I just feel like I can't pull them off. Like, what are different ways you can wear it?
So, in what way do you not feel like you can pull it off? Like, what is it? Is it shape, or is it because you feel like it's a lot?
I feel like I could just do leggings, and that's it. And I'm like, or leggings and like a shirt. And I don't know.
So you could do like, so with kimonos, because there's so much volume.
I guess I just don't know how to wear them, I guess.
So you don't, you want to balance it out somewhere. You don't want to have like big pantalon, top. So what I would say probably is to do something a little bit slimmer fitting up top, and then you could have a little bit more volume on the bottom. You could do a jean, you could do a legging. Do you own any skinny jeans?
Yeah,
you could definitely do a skinny jean with them, and that would be totally appropriate. You could also do shorts when it gets warmer out. You could do a little cut off, and that would be super cute, or a rolled denim.
And then just like a tank top? Or
you could do a tank top. You could do a three-quarter sleeve. I prefer a tank top because I don't like a lot of stuff like messing around with what, I mean, this is a lot happening.
Yeah.
There's a lot of print. There's some tassels. So you don't, for me, it would just feel too fussy having, you know, a big sleeve or anything like that. Yes.
I was told if you're a little overweight, never wear stripes because they enhance your weight.
It depends on the width of the stripe.
Because I love stripes.
Okay.
So I don't want to wear something that makes me look bigger than I really
do. So it depends on the width and the placement of the stripes. My friend Stephanie has a beautiful curvaceous figure, and she likes stripes, but she chooses them to be like blocked in certain areas. So like maybe down here. She had a really cool, we went to this dinner dance and she had a blocked striped dress. So it was like it was stripes, but they were very wide. So it was like a black, a red, and a cream. Also a very fine, we have a great splendid top. It's in gray and the stripe is so fine in it that it wouldn't add to your bust line. But that's something you kind of have to play around with and just be open to trying different things on, because I have had a lot of customers with like, I couldn't try that on. And it's like, well, if you don't give it a try, like, you just have to be open to trying new things, because then you'll never know if it really doesn't look good. Like, I had a customer who was turning 70. She was told her entire life by her mother that she could not wear hunter green. And I got her into a hunter green dress, and she looked spectacular. But she was open enough to come in, and she trusted me to be like, just try it. I promise, it's gonna be okay. She was open to hearing that, open to trying, and then she found something that she liked. So that's a really big part of incorporating new things or things that you didn't think that you could ever wear into your wardrobe. Yes.
Does Helena's for alterations?
No.
Okay.
We don't. I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Is there something in particular that you're thinking about altering, or is it just alterations in general?
I think it's just looking at some of the pants here, and I'm here a lot because I work next door, and I normally tend to buy the tops, and I don't think about the pants because they're all very long for me. So I just wanted to throw it out there. There's just something in ease about just being in the same shop where they offer that versus having to go elsewhere.
Yes, absolutely.
So I was just curious.
And we've had different relationships with different tailors that we can try to send people to. You know, denim is almost always long for just about everybody. And so we're good about like quoting prices for what it might be to get a pair of denim pants. And we found that people just have different preferences and expectations about what they want. You know, if someone wants a pair of pants hem, sometimes they want them a little longer than another person. But yes, it is a conundrum for a lot of different heights, because even someone who's 5'5" needs to get the denim hem.
What's the best way to organize your closet? Mm-hmm. I recently color coordinated my closet from like sleeveless to knit to whatever, and it just makes it so much easier in the morning to know what you're trying to coordinate with.
Yes.
What? But.
So the way that my closet at home is organized is by style of top and color. So I have all my tanks together, and I have all my black ones together, all my, you know, and I do it like that, and then I go over to my, you know, blouses, and then I have collared shirts, and then I have sweaters, and then, you know, it just goes on. And it's a really great way to do the color coding, because then you realize if you have a problem. Like for me, I have too many cream peasant-y type tops. Like I know, like I can pump my brakes when something new comes in, and I'm like, I need to have this, but I'm like, seven others. So it's a good way to organize it. Like when you do go home and you look at your closet, that's a great way to categorize things and color code. Anyone else? Thank you so much. Yes, thank you.